Question. Are you still watching Queen Modjadji or have you fallen off? The reason I'm asking this question is because I have noticed that the series hasn't gained as much popularity in comparison to other Nguni stories. And I understand that there are people who may not be familiar with the history of Modjadji, the Rain Queen. However, this is a good time to actually be accustomed and to learn more about it because I remember the first time I even heard about Queen Modjadji was in 2008. I think I was doing my first year at Vert School of Arts. That's when I came into realization of this great history that exists. And on my part, maybe it was partly ignorance because I really didn't know about it up until then. However, back into the present, I realized that we need more South African stories, and Queen Modjadji is one of those stories that we really need to know because there are some people who still don't know about it, and this could be a good time to, learn more. And also, maybe it can inspire us to find out more about other African heroes, other stories that have not been taught in schools, stories that make part of our history. And I had to sit back and ask myself, what could be the reason as to why the ratings of Queen Modjadji are not as high? Well, first and foremost, the budgeting. Obviously, the budget is not going to be the same as maybe Ushaka Zulu. I know Ushaka Zulu had a huge budget. However, Queen Modjadji does have a smaller budget. But that doesn't take away from how the creators, created this beautiful scenery and this and brought the story back to life. It doesn't take away from how the actors are doing so well. And by the way, my favorite character is Dungundini. I don't care what you think. I don't care what you say. Okay? I just feel Uguti, she was played a lot. So she turned out to be the way she turned out. She is my favorite character. Right? But I do feel that in terms of the marketing didn't really hit the right audience because I remember when it premiered on our screens, I think it was the 15th of July, and it didn't do as well as I thought it would because I went and checked into social media, I just wanted to see if it would cause that big I wanted to see if a lot of people were watching it. Yes, there were a few things up, over the socials, but not enough to make people interested. So I feel like they should have invested more on social media because that would have created more of a hype and actually get more people to watch it. And I looked at Twitter as well, and I noticed that in Twitter, yes, the actors did post about it, but I felt that they were not really interactive. And besides the fact that they told us, oh, today is the premiere, they didn't really engage with the people in terms of like really making us aware of the history of the Rain Queen. Because you have to understand that if a lot of people might not know about it, you need to create the hype around it so that a lot of people actually watch with anticipation and excitement. So I felt like more emphasis could have been done in terms of the social media. That would have worked out very well. And also, In terms of the creation of the story, yes, the cinematography is amazing. There's also something that I actually picked up on Twitter. I don't know if a lot of people picked up on that. There was this comment where a person said, "Oh, so it's a story about the rain queen, and I just know that a lot of Zulu people are gonna be in it." And somebody said Pogunani, and they said, "No, we just feel ukuthi Lobedu people should be the one to actually be the characters." And I do agree, but that is problematic because in itself, I felt that that comment kind of comes from a very tribalist place with both parties involved. Because, for one, to be honest, there are more non-Lobedu dramas, soapies, and content that is being created in South Africa. So, if we say that, okay, fine. It should be a person who is this tribe so that the story becomes more authentic. From a dialect point of view and from the richness of the language, I do understand where people are coming from because there is a huge difference to it. A person, owancela ilimi ebeleni, and umuntu who just learned it. There's a huge difference. And if we have abantu who are now doing roles, specifically with autobiography roles, we want it to be as authentic as possible. But then the double-edged sword is that the same could be said with non-Lobedu dramas, series, and movies because people would then say, if that's the case, then the same should be done for Sotho dramas, for Zulu and Xhosa dramas. And at the end of the day, acting is a craft. Acting is a skill that some people are very passionate about and they take a lot of time learning. So if we now say that it should be a person who belongs to that tribe. It also means that a lot of people will be out of jobs. That's just the reality. But with that being said, I do understand where people are coming from. And it also got me thinking, Ogoti, what else could have been done? Like, honestly, what else could have been done? I lean heavily on the social media. Maybe I'm just being biased because it's me, but social media is how you attract a lot of young people. And in order for something to make people more interested, it has to be trending on the socials. And unfortunately, I didn't think that it trended enough because even today, which is a Sunday, what's the date today? I don't even remember the date today. It's Sunday, the 18th of August. And it hasn't really been trending much. So that's why I keep on asking, are you still watching Queen Modjadji? And if you are, what are the most interesting things that you have learned? And if you are not, what made you not continue watching it? And also, another thing that I felt might have also affected in terms of the views, in terms of the engagement of the people, but not so much. I felt that there was an article that was written on the 9th of July in, what's the publication? It's Times Life, where they said that the royal family is trying to stop the production from actually being aired on screen, which I found a bit confusing and weird, because weren't they part of the creation of the story? Meaning, weren't they asked, didn't they visit the village? Didn't they get permission? But I don't think they needed that much of a permission. But I would like to know, what is it that made the Balobedu royal family want to remove the Queen Modjadji out, you know, of the DSTV? What is it that actually turned them off with the production? Because clearly there's a story there, you know, but maybe someone somewhere has all the answers. I don't know. But from a person who's just observing, I am enjoying it. I am enjoying it because I feel that we need more stories. I feel that we need more stories that are about women, you know, because sometimes when you think of kingdoms, we never think of kingdoms that are ruled by women per se. And truly, they are kingdoms that were successful and they were run by women, which also goes to show that Africa was not necessarily a patriarch society. But then, you know what happened. Anyways, let me know if you're still watching Queen Modjadji and how you are finding it. And up until next time,